Hello, friends. Amy R. here with Prairie Paper and Ink with the Simon Says Stamp September 2021 card kit. Disclaimer, as always, the kits are sent to me. I don't have to do the unboxings, etc. I just like doing them. They're fun. And yeah, let's just dive right into it. So this is the Let's Celebrate card kit. Oh, so much fun stuff. So you get your little bit of candy, love. There's this fabulous embossing folder. This is the Minted Florals embossing folder, love. There is a wafer die set that's sold separately that will work with this. I already ordered it. As soon as I saw it, I was like, oh, that's perfect, because it'll die cut out all the flowers, which is super fun. You could hand trim them, but that's just, who wants to do that? So there is a die set separately. I'll have links like always. So you get an embossing folder. There's the happy birthday wafer die. So you've got the die, like the word, and the outline. So you get that. And then the fabulous little stamp set. You get the Let's Celebrate 6x8 stamp set. Cute little banner. I love the sentiment. Got all the sort of little, you know, cupcake, cake, balloons, you know, all this fun little stuff. Such a cute set. And again, there is a coordinating wafer die set for this that's sold separately. So I will link to that. And then there's these, ooh, I like. These are the disco ball sequins. Oh, love. And another triangle tray. I love my triangle trays. I have many from many different brands. Love. You guys see me use these in practically all my videos because I just love them for, you know, dumping my embellishments in, being able to pick out what I need, and then, like, they're just perfect. So you get one in the kit. That's kind of cool. So there's that. And then the pattern paper this time is Vicky Booten's American Crafts Sweet Rush, and it's 6x8, which I love. And, oh, again, the colors. Oh, these are fun. I love. These are fun papers. Oh, aren't they pretty? The Vicky Booten papers are always just, I like her style. Oh, I love it. I love it. Oh, that's really pretty. These are so fun. So fun. So you get those. You get the beautiful sparkly cardstock. It can vary, it says. So either you'll either get like pink or there's a blue. I love Simon's Glitter cardstock. It doesn't shed. Die cuts like a dream. I've been using this stuff for years. Oh, love. Like, look. Isn't that beautiful? So you get that. There's also rainbow holographic paper. Again, lovely. This stuff embosses amazingly. I've done some of the other foil paper that Simon has, and it embosses like with the 3D embossing folders. The only thing I do is I usually will just lightly mist the non-foiled side just to soften it a bit before running it through with the embossing folder so it doesn't crack. And yeah. It's beautiful. I'm just going to turn it over so it doesn't keep freaking out my camera. So you get that. You get cardstock, of course. Lovely cardstock. Fabulousness. So you get doll pink, island blue, and then this is Nina 110 solar white. Great for card bases. Also great for Copic coloring. Lovely. And then a couple of envelopes. You got the metallic doll pink. One of my faves. And then an A2 white envelope. So yeah, love, love. So that's a kit in a nutshell. Like always, I will link to the kit. I'll link to everything available individually. I'll link to the coordinating die sets, yada, yada, yada. Like always, that will be in the description box below, as well as a link to my blog. That's always the first link, because in the blog post, it's the photos in the blog post, picture links, etc. It's all there to make it easier for everyone to find all of the things, and then just keep watching to see what I make. I'm not even sure what I'm gonna make at the moment. I'm just like, ooh, shiny, pretty things. I'm totally distracted by all of this, which is just funny. But yeah, what a fun little set. So, just stay tuned and we will see what I come up with.
Okay, so I went with that floral pattern paper that I was like, oh my god, it's amazing. I trimmed it down into two separate pieces. And then I am going to run this through my embossing or my die cut machine with that minted florals embossing folder. Now, with the Simon folders and my machine, I'm using the Spellbinders extended plate system. I've shown this a few times now. With Simon's folders, what works best for me is the platform A and then a cutting plate. So that's their labeled C. And then my folder with the cardstock in it. I lightly missed the paper, regardless of what type I'm using, pattern paper, cardstock, etc. And then run that through the paper, or the misting just helps impress better, as well as kind of prevent cracking. And with pattern paper, depending on the pattern on the paper, will determine how the pattern shows up. Like on camera, you don't really see much, even in real life, because it's a busy pattern paper. More subtle pattern papers work as well. Like you can see the backsides of these, you can really see the pattern. But later on, I'm going to add a little something to enhance it. But in real life, you can see the texture in that, and it's just fun. So my next step was to heat emboss that happy birthday sentiment that I also loved. I took a piece of Strathmore watercolor paper from my stash and I put it in my Misti. I used my anti-static powder tool on the watercolor paper. And then I'm inking up that sentiment with clear embossing ink. And I'm going to stamp it twice each time just to make sure I get all of it and all the detail, because there's a lot going on with that little sentiment. And then I just flipped the paper around so I could stamp it a second time. Once I've got it stamped, I'm going to cover this with Detail Gold embossing powder from Simon. And there were still spots that I managed to have stray emboss powder stick to. It happens. I don't often show this on camera just because usually I've got the paper like right under my nose, so I'm not on camera when I do this. But when there's little things like that, I just take a dry paintbrush and I wipe away wherever there are bits of embossing powder that I don't want. So I wipe that away, then I heat emboss, I'm good to go. So melt this with my heat tool till it is completely melted and smooth and shiny and fabulous. And then I'm going to watercolor these with my Karen Brush Marker Pro Markers. I just picked out a bunch of colors that went with pattern paper, and I did take pictures of the colors I used. That'll be on my blog. I'll have an image with the specific colors. And I'm also using my Tonic Aqua Shimmer Pen that I've been showing in tons of videos lately. All I did was squeeze the Aqua Shimmer Pen onto a palette, and then I'm just dipping my paintbrush into water first, and then picking up a bit of the shimmer. And then after I've scribbled, like I scribbled the marker onto the watercolor paper, I dip my brush in water, swirl it in the shimmer, and then paint. I could just color with the marker and then paint with the Aqua Shimmer Pen. However, the Aqua Shimmer Pen will like start pulling up the color into the brush pen. And I don't want that, especially when I'm switching from color to color to color to color. It's just a pain in the butt. It's easier to do it separately like this, especially with these Karen brush markers, because they're like, some of these colors are intensely pigmented and it's just easier keeping things separate. So using either a brush like this, or sometimes I've used like a little water brush that works pretty good. And then I usually will have like off camera, a little cloth or a little bit of paper towel, something to like wipe my brush in between colors, again, to prevent everything from contaminating, or if I'm using something like a water brush, etc., to keep the color from getting wicked like into the barrel. So I had no rhyme or reason when coloring this. Like I didn't go in rainbow order. I was just like throwing colors down because I was like, let's mix it up a little bit. Not everything has to be in rainbow order, even though everything looks fabulous in rainbow order, you know? So I painted that, and then I repeated the exact same thing with the exact same colors on the second one. And then once those are dry, I just trim those out with my scissors. And then this is where I'm going to add something. Again, subtle. I'm using a white pigment ink pad. This is the Ink on 3 Shark Tooth White Fusion ink pad. This is one of my favorite white ink pads. I'm not applying pressure. I'm just letting kind of gravity do its thing, you know, holding the ink pad, and then lightly rubbing this all across the raised areas of this pattern paper. Again, subtle. I didn't want to cover the pattern paper, but, you know, that little bit of pigmenting, it just kind of brings out a little bit more of the detail. But I didn't want it to be, you know, more busy, more crazy, whatever. Again, depending on the pattern and what you're going for, you could also use other colors of pigment inks. That would work really nice too. But this was the, like, most subtle neutral option. So I also pulled out some just navy cardstock for my stash, just to tie in with that navy color on the pattern paper. And I had trimmed that to just slightly larger than these panels, and I adhered them together with some craft tacky glue. And then those sentiments that I had watercolored and then trimmed out, I backed with foam squares. So they've got popped up with some dimension here. So get those popped into place. And then for the insides of my cards, I'm going to stamp them with sentiments from that Let's Celebrate stamp set. And I'm going to use Simon's Peony ink for the main sentiment. So stamp those onto the insides of each card. And then I'm going to use Royal ink, and I'm just going to add a little sub sentiment beneath that, just to kind of tie in the pink and the blue of, like, again, the pattern paper, the front of the card, etc. So I just use my little acrylic blocks for that. And once I've got those stamped, I'll be adhering the card fronts to the card base, again, just with craft tacky glue, because I'm going to have enough texture and dimension going on between the embossing and then the sentiments, you know, popped up with foam squares. And then, of course, bling. I really love this disco ball bling you get in the kit. It's really pretty. I put a ton on these cards. Since I get everything rather simple, it didn't look too busy to just, I put a ton, you know, usually I put a few here and there. I just sprinkled a ton of it all over both of these cards. And then once I was just happy with the placement, I'm going to adhere all of that into place with craft tacky glue. Again, just using my little embellishment wand to pick it up. And then I'll pair these cards with metallic doll pink envelopes. You get one in the kit. And then, of course, I always have a stash of these with all my envelopes. And then I will use my flashlight to show you guys the bling. And then I'll also turn off the lights, like my little studio lights, so you guys can see the actual embossed texture a little better. Because like I said, it just kind of gets washed out in my videos. But yeah, the sentiments are all sparkly and gold embossed and shiny. It's just fun. So that's the, you know, main sentiment with these. And this one I really was able to pick up the glitter. Some days I have good filming days where my camera will pick it up. And then other times it's like, nope. So outsides are all fun and colorful. Inside's a little more simple. Wanted the focus to be on the sentiments. And then, yeah, I'll turn off a couple of my lights to try and show that embossed texture. I really like this embossing folder, but I say that with every, like, embossing folder Simon releases. But this one's really fun. It's fun. So, yeah, got all that texture going on. And again, my camera's like, what are you doing? Why? So, yeah. Really fun. It's neat having like a floral texture on a floral pattern paper. You know, it's like texture on texture. Anyway, as always, like I mentioned earlier in the video, I'll have a link below the video to my blog post. I'll have all the supplies, picture links in the blog post, all that info. You can check that out directly below in the description box if you're interested. Thank you all so much for watching and subscribing and thumbs upping and commenting. I very much appreciate it. And I'll see you all very soon in the next video. Bye.